Clark, fare thee well, I'm gone. Fare thee well, old Joe Clark, I better be getting on. Old Joe Clark had a house 16 stories high. Every story in that house was filled with chicken pie. Oh, fare thee well, old Joe Clark, fare thee well, I'm gone. Fare thee well, old Joe Clark, I better be getting on. I went down to old Joe's house, never been there before. He slept on a feather bed and I slept on the floor. Oh, I went
Andy?
Down to...
Come here, boy.
Yes, sir?
You should have been on your way to town a half hour ago.
I'll have the wagon loaded in a minute, Pa. I just have a couple more sacks of grain.
Well, get that wagon loaded and get out of here. I want you back by noon, understand?
Yes, sir.
I got work first to do.
Yes, sir. I'll be back in time.
And boy.
Yes, sir.
Don't let me catch you loafing again here.
I wasn't loafing, Pa, honest.
Singing like a fool. You're no bird. You're a half-grown man. And a man's joy is to work. Not to sing. Hear?
Yes, sir, I hear you.
And drop off a sack of feed to Cartwright's. We've owed it to him for a week now.
Yes, sir, I will.
Filled with chicken pie. Oh, fare thee well, old Joe Clark. Fare thee well, I'm gone. Fare thee well, old Joe Clark. Better be getting on. Oh, I went down to old Joe's house. I never been there before. He slept on a feather bed and I slept on the floor. Oh, fare thee well, old Joe Clark. Fare thee well, I'm gone. Fare thee well, old Joe Clark. I better be getting on. Old Joe had a yellow cat. Neither sing nor pray. She stuck her head in a buttermilk jar and washed her sins away. Oh, fare thee well, old Joe Clark. Fare thee well, I'm gone. Fare thee well, old Joe Clark. I better be getting on. The higher up the cherry tree, the riper grows the cherry. The more you hug and kiss the girls, the sooner they will marry. Oh, fare thee well, old Joe Clark. Fare thee well, I'm gone. Fare thee well, old Joe Clark. I better be getting on.
How you doing, Annie?
Oh, hi, little Joe. I'm just bringing back that grain your pa lent us.
Well, there was no hurry with it. Thanks anyway. How things going at your place?
You know, Pa's been keeping me busy. We've been clearing that new ground, and that doesn't leave me too much time for anything else. Pa wants to plow it this fall. Have you heard anything from Adam?
Yeah, got a letter from him last week. He's in Paris now. He's gonna spend the winter and spring there.
Boy. Would I love to see some of those places. My ma used to always tell me about London and Paris and Rome, and she'd been to every one of them.
Well, who knows? You might get to see them someday.
Those places might as well be on the other side of the moon as far as I'm concerned. I'm lucky to get off the farm long enough to go to Virginia City.
Yeah, well, that makes two of us. You going into town?
Yeah.
Listen, give me time to saddle up my horse. I'll go with you.
Sure.
Buy you a beer. Although that is, if your pa don't mind.
Well, I've never had a beer, even been in a saloon, for that matter. I guess it's about time.
Good deal. I'll be with you in a minute.
Good.
Thank you.
Very good, very good. I see you got the wagon unloaded.
Yeah, the sacks gave out about 10 seconds before I did.
Well, I don't know about you. I'm ready for the beer. Come on.
No, maybe I better.
Ah, come on, Andy. One beer's not going to hurt anything.
Hey, that song. Where's it coming from?
Andy, it is coming from the same place where we're going to get the beer. Come on, let's go. Lovely ribbons, scarlet ribbons for her hair. Come on, Lil, pick it up. Your feet are dragging.
Look, at this hour of the morning, I'm lucky to be standing on them.
All the stores were closed and shuttered. All the streets were dark and bare. In our town, no scarlet ribbons.
Howdy. Good morning, old Joe.
Have a couple of beers, Cosmo.
Right away.
Just before the dawn was breaking, I peeked in and on her bed in gay profusion lying there. Lovely ribbons, scarlet ribbons.
Two beers, old Joe.
Yeah, thanks, Cosmo. Andy, your beer's here.
I will never know from where came.
What's the matter? You want something stronger?
No, it's not that.
Huh?
Lovely ribbons. It's not that.
What? I can't hear you.
I said she's singing it all wrong.
I haven't even finished my first cup of coffee, and already I've got a critic.
He didn't mean anything by that, Miss Lily. He was just kidding you.
Yes, ma'am. You got a right to sing it any way you want to.
Oh, even if I was singing it all wrong, huh?
Yes, ma'am. Even then.
Whoever made you a critic, Mr. whatever your name is?
My ma, she didn't make me an expert on music, but she did teach me how that song ought to be sung.
Hey, Mike, let's listen to the maestro here. Let him show us how the song really ought to be done.
Well, sure, if you really want me to.
Step right up, take stage.
The way you did it was just fine, except a little bit slower.
I peeked in to say goodnight. Then I heard my child in prayer. And for me, some scarlet ribbons, scarlet ribbons. For my hair, all the stores were closed and shuttered.
Hey, kid, keep going.
No, I better not.
Well, I've heard enough to know you've got a beautiful voice.
Well, it gets the hogs in for feeding at least.
Well, you sure surprised me, Andy. I thought it was great.
Thank you, Joe.
How long you been studying, kid?
Well, the only studying I ever did is what my ma used to teach me.
But why'd she stop?
She died 4 years ago. Well, I better be getting back because my pa wouldn't like my being here. See you, Joe.
No, I'm coming with you. Take it easy. Thanks for the beer, Cosmo.
Sure.
You ain't eating. You're sick.
No, Pa, I'm fine. I was just thinking.
Well, thinking don't stick to your ribs like stew. They won't get that plow picked up in town tomorrow.
I haven't forgotten the plow, Pa. I'm just remembering that piano we had when Ma was with us. Did you ever think about getting us another piano, Pa?
No.
I just thought it'd be nice to have a little music around the house, that's all.
We had music around when your Ma was alive. When she died, so did music. What got you thinking about a piano?
Oh, nothing, Pa. It just crossed my mind, that's all.
Well, uncross it. Maybe birds got time for songs, but farmers don't.
Ma used to say it, the whole world's a song if you just listen hard enough.
Yeah, she did say that. But she's gone. There'll never be another like her.
You're right, Pa. There'll never be anybody like her. Thank you, Pa.
Hey, Mike, play the kids' version of the Scarlet Ribbons, hmm?
Picture this. We had half the place mad with us because we played Dixie, and the other half is mad because we played Battle Hymn of the Republic. Now, if you think this is such an easy job, what do you think we played to keep peace?
Beats me.
God Save the Queen confused them all. Well, I think I'm gonna go over and see if I got any room at the barber shop. No, just a trim. Lily, why don't you ask Andy about, you know, what we talked about the other night?
Yes, I will.
What were you supposed to ask me about?
Andy, how would you like to work here?
Me? I don't know how to do anything in a saloon.
Well, you can sing.
Yeah, but I'm not a real singer.
But you could be. And I could start teaching you. Look, Andy, I've been around singers, sweet and sour, all of my life. And I know you can make it.
No, my pa'd never let me. Working in a saloon.
It's not what you work inside of that counts, Andy. It's what's inside of you. Don't you want to sing? I think you'd like to try it, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I guess I would.
Then ask your pa. Just ask him. For me.
I better be getting home. Bye, Miss Lily.
Bye.
But it's not as if I'll be away when you need me, Pa.
I've said all I'm gonna say about it, boy.
Okay, Pa, you've had your say. Now let me have mine.
You already have.
But, Pa, she's just gonna teach me how to sing right, that's all.
Disrespect for your father's what she'll be teaching you. I don't want you having anything to do with a saloon girl like her.
Pa, she's a nice lady, and she says I got a real good voice.
I've said all I'm gonna say about it, boy.
But, Pa, all I want is...
What you want don't matter. Can't you understand that?
Yeah, Pa, I'm getting to understand that real well.
What's that mean?
It means I've had enough of that kind of talk, Pa. Now I'm warning you.
You're warning me? Just what you got in mind, Mr. Big Britches?
I'll leave, Pa. I'll leave and I'll never come back.
You can pack up and get out anytime suits you.
But, Pa, I'm your son.
I lost my son about 30 seconds ago.
Well, Mom, I'm leaving. I don't think it's anybody's fault. It's just the natural way of things. I can't be just a son for always. I gotta be a man on my own. So it's natural for a son to leave. But it ain't natural that it's gotta be done with so much pain. Pa's been afraid ever since you left, Mom. It's like he thinks the only thing that he can love is just the earth. Not the people. Not the things they do. But just the earth. Ma used to always tell me that if I listened real hard, I could hear the breeze singing. Well, I hope someday a good breeze will come along. And you'll be able to hear me too. Goodbye, Ma.
How you doing?
Fine, just fine, little Joe.
Yeah, I can see that by the sign.
Yeah, just fine if you overlook the fact that I left home and I'm flat broke.
You sure you're doing the right thing?
Yeah, and don't try to talk me out of it because I've made my own decision. And I'm gonna be a singer. Miss Lily's gonna help me.
Look, I wasn't trying to talk you out of anything. I was trying to talk you into a job. We got some horses out at the ranch that need breaking. We need another man.
Not anymore, you don't.
We got a deal. Come on down to the stable. I'll get your horse. How you doing?
I have had some day. I feel like I've been busting Bronx for a week.
Are you trying to tell me you're not going to sit down for dinner? Listen, I want to tell you, I'm real proud of you, though. You didn't know, but I had an eye on you today. You did real fine.
Well, thank you for giving me the job.
Well, thank you for taking it. Of course, don't rest on your laurels. We got quite a tough batch of horses picked out for you tomorrow. Nothing like those feather beds you were on today.
None of those feather beds like you had today. You could have gone all week without saying that.
Come on, I'll get you some liniment.
Okay.
The pipes are calling from glen to glen and down the mountainside. The summer's gone and all the roses are falling. Tis you, must go, and I must bide. But come ye back when summer's on the meadow, or when the vale is hushed and white with snow. It's I'll be here when sunlight are in shadow. Oh, Danny boy, oh, Danny
Andy, I don't know nobody named Danny, but doggone it, every time I hear that, it chokes me up.
I think maybe the way Andy was singing it had something to do with that horse.
Gee, I hope Adam doesn't mind my using his guitar.
Oh, heck, none of us can play. It was just gathering dust till you picked it up.
You keep playing it that way. I understand you're taking some singing lessons, too.
Well, sorta. I mean, not from a real teacher. It's just Miss Lily down at the Silver Dollar.
Now, Andy, just because Miss Lily sings to the Silver Dollar doesn't mean that she can't sing or teach.
Hey, they offered you a job over there at the Silver Dollar, didn't they?
Yeah, start this Friday if I want to.
Did you tell your pa about this?
Well, I better be getting over to the bunkhouse. I got a long day tomorrow. Good night, fellas. Excuse me, sir. Good night.
Good night, Andy. Good
night, Andy.
Good night,
Andy.
Pa, I wish somebody could, I don't know, talk to his father, try to explain the boy's side of it.
Yeah. Well, let's go to bed.
Yeah.
So come me back when summer's in the meadow, or when the valley's hushed and white with snow. For it's be there.
Bad, huh?
Thank you.
We ain't got nothing to say to each other.
Well, something I'd like to say to you. You know, Andy's working at the Ponderosa.
You can tell him from me. Ain't no use sending you here begging my forgiveness.
Well, he didn't send me here.
There's doers and there's dreamers in this world, Ben. And a dreamer's just bound to get in my way. His mother did that. She was a good woman. Meant a whole lot to me, she did. But she had her head in the clouds. Head and heart, too, for all I know.
She was a fine woman.
And she never seemed to understand that life is hard facts. She taught Andy to think like she did. Singing ain't gonna fix this old fence of mine.
Now, Willard, the way Andy sings, you ought to be proud of him. Do you know that people are paying to hear him sing?
For money? Where?
At the Silver Dollar.
I'd be obliged if you'd let me get out of the work, Ben Cartwright.
All right, Willard. You keep right on building that fence. You make sure it's real strong so nobody can get in. And make sure it's real high so nobody can look in and see how alone Willard Walker really is.
Me, a little respect. Thank you, boys, thank you. Tonight we have a real surprise for you. A brand new, wonderful singing talent. A young man from your own Virginia City, Mr. Andrew Walker. Hey!
To say goodnight, then I heard my child in prayer. Send, dear God, some scarlet ribbon, scarlet ribbon for my hair. All the stars were closed and shuttered. All the streets were dark and bare. In our town, no scarlet ribbons.
Hey, Lily. Sam here just told a story.
Sam just told a story that's going to get you thrown out of here on your backside if you don't shut up and listen. Now, pipe down, you galoots.
Just before the dawn was breaking, I peeked in, and on her bed, in gay profusion, lying there, lovely ribbons, scarlet ribbons, scarlet ribbons for her hair. If I live to be 200, I will never know from where came those lovely scarlet ribbons, scarlet ribbons for her.
farewell. Old Joe Clark better be getting on. Old Joe Clark had a house 16 stories high. Every story in that house was filled with chicken pie. Farewell, old Joe Clark, farewell and gone. Farewell, old Joe Clark better be getting on. I went down to old Joe's house, never been there before. He slept on a feather bed and I slept on the floor. I went down to old Joe's.
Come on, mister. We don't want any trouble.
Leave him alone!
How much more shame and humiliation I gotta take on account of your singing, boy?
No more, Paul. No more.
Thought I'd come over and see how you're doing.
Fine.
I talked to Lily. She wanted me to come over and tell you how bad she felt about the other night. She kind of feels responsible for what happened.
It wasn't her fault, Joe. It wasn't anybody's fault but mine. Disobeyed my father, little Joe. I disgraced him by making a public spectacle out of myself by singing in a saloon. But I'll never do it again. Because I'll never sing again.
Oh, look, that doesn't make sense. There was nothing wrong with what you did. There's nothing wrong with singing.
Singing's a sin, little Joe. My pa made me see it, and I see it. I hurt him, and I humiliated him. I'll never sing again.
Take it easy. That wagon load of horseshoes?
Yeah. I also run into Andy in town. Looks like you had that situation pretty well figured out.
Yeah.
He don't laugh anymore. He don't smile. Doesn't seem like he enjoys life at all. Getting more like old Willard every day.
Yeah, I was afraid of that. His father's got him convinced that singing and laughing are a sin.
Just sorry to hear that.
Well, it looks like there ought to be something we could do. I mean, get them together and talk to them. Maybe invite them over for dinner or something, huh?
Hey, what about on Easter Sunday?
I think we ought to do something like that. That gives me an idea.
Like what?
You fellas go ahead and eat. I got me an errand to do.
Good afternoon, Willard.
Afternoon, Robert.
Willard, I brought Reverend Porter along because, well, there's something that he thinks you can help him with. If you will, that is.
Well, if I can, I expect I'll help.
Well, Willard, you might say this concerns my entire congregation. As you know, Easter services will be held in a few days, and,
Well, what Reverend Porter's trying to say is that he'd like Andy to sing in his church on Easter Sunday.
Well, that's hard to say. There's chores and...
Willard, in church, now, there's nothing heathenish about that, is there? I mean, he's not going to be doing the devil's work in Reverend Porter's chapel now, is he?
Well, I never thought of it.
Your wife used to sing for us, Willard. And I'm told that Andy here has her same feeling for a song. It would certainly be a shame if that feeling couldn't be put to use for the benefit of the Lord on that most holy of days.
Yeah, sure would be a shame. But it's up to you, Willard. Andy's your son.
The boy can make up his own mind. He did before.
It's your decision, son. But I think I know what your mother would want you to do.
Yes, sir. I'll sing if you want me to.
Well, you got what you come for. If you'd let us get on with our work now.
Hello, Andy. Little Joe told me I'd find you here. I came to congratulate you.
What for?
Because of your singing again. You are going to sing again, aren't you?
Reverend Porter asked me to. It's not the same. It used to be that singing was like a deep breath on a spring morning to me. Now it's something I'll do because I said I would, that's all. There's no joy anymore.
But Andy...
It's true, Miss Lily. You saw my father in the saloon. It doesn't matter whether he's right or wrong. I just know that I never want to be the cause of that much pain again.
Andy, I suppose I'm the last one to talk about what's right or wrong, but well, there's one thing I know. If there's anything in this whole world that's right, it's your singing. That joy will return, Andy. I know it will.
Mr. Cartwright.
Where's your pa?
I guess he isn't coming.
Well, it's Easter Sunday.
Well, he's clearing the new field. He says that going to church is a waste of time.
You go on ahead. I'll catch up with you. Willard, let me help you with that.
No, I can get it alone.
Well, it's going to take all morning, isn't it?
I ain't got nothing else to do.
Well, aren't you coming to church with me?
What for? Listen to that boy bellow like a sick calf? No.
Willard, mean an awful lot to the boy.
I got more important things to do here. Lord made a man to work, didn't he?
Well, even the Lord rested on the seventh day when he looked at his labor and saw it was good.
If you're going to quote the Bible at me, Ben, what about the fifth commandment? Honor thy father.
It's a commandment that I've lived by. An unwritten one. Honor thy son.
I ain't wrong. A man was made for work. What else are we good for?
They said unto them, Why seek ye the living among the dead? He is not here, but is risen.
Stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and pain. How I love that old cross, the dearest and best, where a world of loss cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross, and someday
my wife used to sing that song. It's beautiful the way he sings it.
Till my trophies at last I lay down, I will.